good carry. Damn it, Karen, that's for emergency use only. Yes, this was at the airport. Sad to say, at the airport in my own city, right here in Atlanta, Georgia. We got all of the information. Let's put up the picture full mass here. Her name is Jennifer. According to Fox 5 Atlanta, the Karen in question is Jennifer Kaye Holder from Dayton, Ohio. Holder was charged with obstructing law enforcement, 2 counts of simple assault, and 3 counts of simple battery. The Atlanta Police Department issued a statement about the arrest. It reads in part, officers attempted to make contact with the female, but she was non-compliant and sprayed officers with the fire extinguisher. Despite being assaulted, officers were able to detain the combative female. And let me add, they did not kill her. 3 airport flight attendants were transported to the hospital with respiratory complaints due to exposure to the discharge extinguisher. Officers relocated the arrestee, Ms. Holder, to the precinct where she continued to behave erratically and combative by spitting and kicking at officers. Once again, she's charged with obstructing. But keep in mind, these charges should have been actually much more severe. Not only did she directly spray chemicals at law enforcement, she continued to physically assault and spit upon them in their own precincts. Did she get accosted in some kind of aggressive manner? No, they used appropriate force. Appropriate, right? Obviously, they were professionals in the way they dealt with this person, because I guarantee you, there are some individuals who would have done all of that. They would have had a whole different experience with the law enforcement agency. Let's put it up. I just thought this was, it's an interesting dynamic. What is the goal? And Rick, I'm going to ask you this, and I hope you really don't give it much thought when you answer. When a Karen has a thought, right? I'm going to grab the fire extinguisher. I'm always wondering, dear brother, what is the conclusion of that thought? What will this thing do to get you from point A to your desired point B?
Well, I think it would require us having that mentality to answer that question, which we don't have.
Don't have it bad.
I mean, immunity from punishment, the ability to criminalize themselves and lack in response any sort of violence. I mean, when you read up on the story, it's interesting. Like, she sprayed folks with the fire extinguisher, including police officers, which is like, it's just the dumbest thing in the world. And she was attempting to open secured doors inside the concourse. And when I dug a little deeper, I saw it was because, I don't know if you saw this, Doc, she allegedly didn't pay for her order at Buffalo Wild Wings.
Yep. She said somebody else paid it. So the story was somebody else paid this, so I don't have to pay for it. That was the story.
Yeah, and you know what? A lot of people talk at the airport. You cozy up to some people, they buy you a drink. I've never heard of them buying you lemon pepper and honey barbecue wings while you're sitting there. But also, it makes me now want wings. Yeah. That's like weird this is. Yeah. I mean, I haven't had B-dubs in like years. I don't think I've had it since college when they offered like 15-cent wings on Tuesdays and then 25-cent wings on Thursdays. Spray it with a fire extinguisher, I think I'd still eat it, honestly. But in all seriousness, I'm hungry. In all seriousness, I guess my question is, doesn't this add to more charges? Because you're spraying someone that could cause respiratory issues. Gee, where have I thought of this. Oh yeah, the 2020 protests.
That's right.
When police officers put tear gas on crowds, why weren't they charged with the same things that this woman potentially could be?
There you go.